तस्मैश्री नमः वंशाकल्पतरुभ्यः कृपासिन्धुभ्यैव च पतितानां पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो नमः। नमो महापतन्नाय कृष्णप्रेम प्रदायते कृष्णाय कृष्ण चैतन्य नाम्ने गौरद्विजे। गुरवे गौरचन्द्राय राधिकायै तदागयै कृष्णाय कृष्णभक्ताय तद्भक्ताय नमो। भक्त्या विहीना अपराधलक्ष्यै क्षिप्त्वाश्च कामादितम् कृपामयीं त्वं शरणं प्रपन्ना वृन्दे नमस्ते चरणाय। यं प्रव्रजन्तमनुपेतमपेतकृत्यं द्वैपायनो विरहकातरया जुहाव पुत्रेति तन्मयतया तर्वोऽभिनेतु तं सर्वभूतहृदयं मुनिमानुतुष। त्वैवास्मि न जिमामि त्वया विना इति विज्ञाय राधे तं माम चरणान्तिके। फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल माय मिलियंस ऑफ ओबेसेंसेस, हम्बल ओबेसेंसेस इन द लोटस फीट ऑफ माय परमाराध्यतम गुरुपाद पद्म नित्य लीला प्रविष्ट विष्णुपाद श्रीमद भक्ति प्रज्ञान के सर्वस्वामी महाराज। एंड अगेन मिलियंस ऑफ मेनी हम्बल ऑफिशियंसेस इन द लोटस फीट ऑफ माय शिक्षा गुरु ओम विष्णुपाद श्रीमद भक्ति वेदांत स्वामी महाराज। We want to explain you that though we have explained in our other session in Hawaii, in Alachua, man, high class of topics, but I want that you should also hear and be a very pure, sincere devotee. So again we are going to explain something. First of all, you should decide and fix the aim and object of your life. First, without this, you have no aim and object of your life. Then you are like animals, your life is useless. So we should know what is the aim of our life, of goal and life of life, and when it will be fixed, then bhakti is Krishna bhakti is the goal of our life. Then something more, what is the process that we can achieve this? We should decide and fix it. So I want to tell you, because you are all devotees here anyhow, that we cannot decide all. The goal of our life, we cannot. But only by the help of Guru and Gauranga, associates of Krishna, by the help of Srimad Bhagavatam, the books of our Goswamis, and especially book of Chaitanya Charitamrita of Krishna Dasa, and And in the Guru Parampara line, Śrīla Bhaktivinoda Thakura, Śrīla Prabhupāda, Śrīla Bhakti Siddhānta Saraswati Thakura. And by the advice of my Siksha Guru, who preached everywhere in Western country, the mission of Goswami and Chaitanya Mahāprabhu, only we can decide on. And that told that Labdhva Sutralabhamidam Bahu Sambhavan Manusham Arthadam Anittamabhi Lapira Purnam Jate Tarnapate Tarnumitta Yavat Nishe Shai Vishuak Vishaya Khalu Sarvatas. That the life of our, goal of our life should be how to make successful our life. To know this thing. And that is what? Krishna Bhakti. Only Krishna Bhakti. If you are not fixing this goal, oh, then your life is useless. You should be in a high class of association and follow the principles of Bhakti. Otherwise, our Goswami has requested, Nityananda Prabhu has requested that all jivas, all living entities of the whole world, you should take shelter of Bhakti, chant and remember what Chaitanya Mahaprabhu told Krishna, and I am responsible for everything for you. So I am also requesting that sincerely we should have this goal of our life. First try to follow Ashraya Bhagavan, Ashraya Krishna, who are present in this world. And then secondly, to Krishna. Who is Ashraya Bhagavan? Who is Krishna Bhagavan? Ashraya. Guru. Sincere, he should be Guru. Not false ego, those who have false ego. Yeah, Guru should be. Tasmāt Guru prapaddet jigyāsu seya uttama. Those who are very expert in all kinds of epics, they can remove your all kinds of doubt. And those who are especially, not only tattva jnana, some realization of love and affection for Krishna. And secondly, they should be detached from worldly sense gratification and other things. Oh, he is good. Even anyone is tattva jnani, he has so much knowledge, but no realization of love and affection for Krishna. He is not really good. He may fall down, but those who have some affection and love for Krishna, and they realized, like Narada Goswami, Sukadeva Goswami, and others, they are really guru. They are very rare in this world. So first serve him, obey him, obey them. They are of two kinds, Diksha Guru and Siksha Guru. All gurus are combined, immortal in this thing. What Pardasha Guru, Chaitya Guru, and all others. So first you should take shelter. And then very easily you can achieve your goal. So in Chaitanya Charitamrita, Śrīla Krishna Das Goswami has told, he had not taken the name of his Diksha Guru. Who was his Diksha Guru? but he has taken the name of his Shikshagu. Sri Rup Sanatan Bhatta Raghunath, Sri Jiva Gopal Bhatta Dasaru. Eight name of four Shikshaguru. For his joint bandana. So we should try to follow. There are two kinds of guru. Parampara. One is Shishya Parampara, another is Guru Parampara. Bhagavat Parampara. In Diksha Guru line, there may it may be that no someone be qualified, some on the unqualified. But in Bhagavat Parampara, all are qualified from Brahma, Narad, and thus Vyas, Sukadeva Goswami, Ishwar Mahavendra Puripad, Ishwar Puripad, then Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, all. Up to now. This is attesting Bhagavat Parampara. All are realized soul. In Guru Shishya Parampara, it may be you will be cheated. Sometimes it will be authentic, sometimes not authentic. So, you should try to know all these things and then serve your Shiksha Guru. First, Diksha Guru ke jani ami Krishna
Swaru.
Na. Shiksha Guru and Diksha Guru is Krishna Swaru, the Roop. Krishna Rupahan Shastra. Or Diksha Guru is Roop. What is the meaning of here Roop?
Form.
Or manifestation. Prakash. And here Shiksha Guru, more something has been added to Roop, Swar. Swar means very near and dear to Krishna. Shiksha Guru. So, you should not avoid Shiksha Guru. Even it may be that Krishna, Srimati Radhika, Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, and Baladev Prabhu. They may be your Shiksha Guru. It has been told, Vandeham in this sloka. So, these Shiksha Guru are not less than your Diksha Guru. If Krishna is Shiksha Guru, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is your Shiksha Guru, Srimati Radhika is your Shiksha Guru, then who is superior? Your Diksha Guru or they? No doubt at all. Don't do. Also, Shiksha Guru, all the Shastra, Veda, Upanishad, and very prominent Srimad Bhagavatam or Shiksha Guru. They are not books, they are Himself, Krishna. Chaitanya Charitamrita and the books of Srila Rupa Goswami. What they are? Shiksha Guru. They are Rupa Goswami Himself. Kaviraj Goswami Himself, not a book, not a merely word. So thus, they have declared and fixed that all jivas are part and parcel of Supreme Lord. All the jivas. Part and parcel. Eternal Nitya Das of Krishna. Jive Swarupa Nitya Krishna Das. So, we are all Nitya Das, eternal servant of Krishna. But even we are called here servant. But in Golok, Vrindavan, Vaikunth and others, no servant at all. All are like bosom friends, or like father, mother, beloved and no servant like this. So, they are told that at the time of finishing Krishna Leela. Krishna was thinking, but I am observer of endless ocean of love and affection. Oh, Raso Vaishya, Akhil Rasamrit Sindhu. What is the meaning of Akhil Rasamrit Sindhu? Oh, endless and deepless, boundless ocean of rasa. What is the rasa? Krishna is a rasa and Krishna is also rasi. Both. So in Krishna pastime, I what relished the sweetness of all kinds of rasas, like dasya, sakya, asal, madhu. I've tasted all kinds of rasas. All served me in any of the rasas. Even shant, but in Braja, no shant. Latin portuguese. The grasses, the sand of Yamuna, mountains, river, they may be cows, they may be told like shantaras, but in Braja, no shantaras at all. The cows are friends of Krishna. Cows are like mother. Mountains like what? Groves and kunjas. Govardhan. Oh, is Vaidha Prakash of Krishna or Radhika. Not a mountain we are having no sense. Oh no. All kinds of senses. And the sands of Yamuna, what? They can vary. They are very greedy for the lotus dust of Lord's feet of gopis and Krishna. When they downfall there. Some trees full of flowers and fruits coming down and giving anjali on the lotus feet of Krishna, like friends, when a friend meets with friends. So they are not of Santaras. They are also of among Dharka, Sakya, Pasal, and Pasal. Even Jamuna River. Oh, not an ordinary river. Or she is Vishakha Shakhi, and she has been transferred into a river. So his collar and Krishna collar are same. Same collar. So the Krishna is thinking very deeply that I have relished all kinds of rasa. I also have repaid all, but not to gopis, my most beloved gopis. And in this world, no one has binded Krishna, Supreme Lord, but Mother Yashoda. And the Supreme Lord Krishna, Nand Baba, ordered, oh, bring my sandal. And he keeping on his head, dancing, coming. And what gopis are doing? I will give her laddu if you dance and sing. And for the greed of the laddu of the gopis. So please gopis, what he is doing? Dancing like this, with swara and dancing. Oh, if you will defeat Baldev, I will give you Laddu. And other parties say, oh, if you will defeat Krishna, I will give you Laddu. And they are wrestling, naked, wrestling. Each other trying to defeat. Shakha, what doing? Defeating Krishna. They are jumping on his shoulders. Oh Krishna, you will have to take me there. You have been defeated. So, I have tested all this. But I could not repay gopis. I could not make any shima,
limit
of the gopi prince. How it is high, how they love, I cannot tell you. Especially the love and affection of my most beloved Sri Radhika is endless. I cannot touch. Whether Krishna is telling true or lie, Krishna is cheating or not, is he cheating us or others? Is he flattering? Never, never, he cannot. You should know that once Krishna told that, oh, gopis, I cannot repay you. Oh, you are lords of Lord, we have heard from Purnamasi Devi and Garga Charge, Bhaguri and others, that you are Supreme Lord. You can repay? How can I repay? I cannot do like you. We cannot give up our husbands, children, father, mother. I cannot give up my Nand Baba Yashoda, never. I cannot give up for one gopi or for Radhika, my most beloved. But I cannot give up any of the gopi. Even anyone in sadhana stage, he is preferred. They want that me they want. Je jathang mam prapadyante tam tatri upajam. I am bound to obey them, to fulfill their desire. But you have left your father, mother, your cousins, aunt and everything, your husband, even your children, everything you have left for me. So, I cannot repay. But even gopis told, oh, you can repay because you are Supreme Lord. Why can't you repay? Oh, it may be that you please me and then I may tell that, oh, you should have any benediction. Then gopis will tell, you will tell what? Give your service, then what will be?
Debt will increase.
Increase, debt will increase. So now pareham nirvadda sanjujan. In thousands of my life, I cannot repay. Oh gopis, please be merciful to me. In Chaitanya Charitamrita it has written, gopis are, oh das. Guru, Sakha, Shishya, Guru also, everything. And in the books of Srila Rupa Goswami it has been told. But who is your Guru? Oh, Radharani. Vrinda told that, Krishna told, from where you are coming? I am coming from Radha. Have you seen or beloved? Oh yes, I have seen. What Krishna is doing there? Oh, he is learning song. From whom? From Radhika. How? He says they prefer Radha, Radha, Radha. And he sees if people tree leaves dancing, other dancer. Oh, he knows that this is the dance of Srimati Radha. I prefer Radha, Radha, Radha. Inside, outside. So my guru is my shishya, my dar, my sarvi, all relations. Oh, in Gopi. And to highest topics in Radhika. How Radhika looks to me? I cannot
understand
measure or kind of weight and measure. Especially, Radhika becomes mad. Seeing me, because she has love and affection, not all love by exception only, but up to Madanakya Mahabhava. Yeah. So she is container or observer of love and affection. I have not that mood, Madanakya Mahabhava. So I don't become mad to see him, her. But she becomes mad. So there is something in me that she becomes mad. And what is that? I don't know. Because she becomes mad to see me. Why she becomes? I cannot calculate, even imagine. Why? I never become mad. She can give up everything for me, but I cannot, because I have not love and affection like her. But there is something in me that it makes mad Srimati Radhika. What is that? Oh, I cannot decide. And what happiness she attained? By testing this Madhurima, Venu Madhuri, Rup Madhuri, Gun Madhuri, and Lila Madhuri. How sweet of mine, I cannot realize how sweet myself, how beautiful myself. If I will see my form,
Reflection
anywhere. Then I wish that I should test it like Radhika Eva. So what is that? And how happiness she feels by seeing all Madhuri Vas. So he thinking what to do. And then Krishna Das.
राधा कृष्ण प्राण मोर जुगल किशोर.
Then he's saying the main word. Gurudev said the main word in our entire vocabulary is when. When will I have the great opportunity in the forests of Kadamba to put them on a throne, on a golden jeweled throne, and on that throne I'll worship them in various ways. I will put unguents on them, on their golden and cloud-like blackish body. I will put unguents of sandalwood paste, kumkum, and other unguents to put designs on their body, and I will fan them with a chamara fan. When will I have that opportunity to behold their beautiful face? In this way, he's teaching us how the process of bhakti, as one advances and advances, he feels more and more separation for this service. He's also teaching that the service of those who have that special inclination towards Srimati Radhika and are serving both Radha and Krishna. They serve Srila Rupa Manjari, but under the guidance of Sakis like Lalita and Vishakha. They work under their guidance, and at the same time, they have a speciality that even Lalita and Vishakha don't have, that they can serve in the most intimate pastimes, where even Lalita and Vishakha have to ask, may I come in now to those manjaris. Then Srila Narottam Das Thakur is concluding that as a servant of the servant of the servant of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, I will render this service when I have the mercy of my Gurudev, of Vaishnavas, of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and his servants, especially in the Rupanuga line. So in this way, Srila Narottam Das Thakur is teaching us how to pray. I asked Gurudev, when I first met him some 10 or so years ago, 11 years ago, I said, Gurudev, I feel like my whole day is taken up in worrying how people are relating to me, judging me, and I'm also finding myself judging people all the time, other devotees. How can I be free from this? So Gurudev said, oh, I have no time for these things because I'm absorbed in the prayers of Srila Narottam Das Thakur like this. This is the way to be free for Premanandi.
Sundar Gopal. What is our aim and object of our life?
Has been told by Narottam Thakur by this song. Stand up and tell. In this prayer song, what has been told? Briefly. No, neither.
In this song, Srila Narottam Das Thakur explains that the ultimate aim and objective of every our ultimate aim and objective is to serve Sri Radha and Krishna as an eternal maidservant of Srimati Radhika.
Why? What is this? This is the goal and this is the aim and object of our life. If anyone has this goal, then what he should do?
Such a person should engage all of his activities in serving Guru and Krishna.
Any examples? You know Raghunath Das Goswami? You know Haridas Thakur? You know Rupa Sanatan? What they have picked? Give them now all the worldly desires and gratification. They will follow like Raghunath. Those his wife was so beautiful, niche was at that universe. And he just, they shake it now. His father, mother, wealth, position, everything. And what taking? Prasadam. Rotten?
Rice grains.
Rotten. With so many vegetables and curd and milk?
Not even with any salt.
And in Vrindavan, what taking?
In Vrindavan, he took just some dry roti.
Only the
personal.
Always weeping, weeping. So if anyone has aim and object like this, oh, they should follow sincerely the film footprints of Raghuna Das and Sarvastham. Thank you. Try to remember. Oh, Jadi Gauranga Nashi. Right?
Jadi Gauranga.
The song by Narahari Das, it is telling about Sri Gauranga Mahaprabhu, who appeared in this world to give this goal of life to all the jivas. What he came to give within this world,
who was he?
Sri Gauranga Mahaprabhu is none other than Sri Krishna himself, coming again with the mood and the complexion of Srimati Radharani, his highest devotee, his highest premi bhakta, the personality.
Don't use bhakta for Radharani. Never.
The personality who is the very ashray vigraha of prem. She is the most beloved of Sri Krishna and the reservoir of all prem.
Even Sri Krishna himself.
So jadi gauranga nahito tabe ke hoito kemone tarita de.
If Krishna has not come in the form of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, then or like this.
So if he had not come, jadi gauranga nahito, if he had not come to this world, then who would ever have known this limit? Radhara Mahima Prema Rasa Sima Jagati Janatoke. Who would in this whole world would have been able to understand and to know this end, this highest limit of prema, as was exhibited by Srimati Radharani, and as Gauranga Mahaprabhu himself desired to taste? Who would have been able to enter into Madhura Brinda Vipina Madhuri Pravesha Chaturi Sar? Even the most expert personalities, they could not understand what is the sweetness of Vrindavan. What is the sweetness of the mood of all the Brijvasis in serving Krishna? And especially, what is the highest nectar, madhuri, of the sweetness of the prema which the gopis experience and the ultimate prema of Srimati Radharani? No one would have been able to even slightly enter into this mood of Braj. No one would have had the ability to understand Bharaja Juvati, the prema of all the gopis of Vrindavan, which, as Gurudev was telling, Krishna himself told he cannot repay. Gao punak punak gaurangera guna sarala hoya man e bhavasagare emona doyala nadeki je ek jan. So he is recommending to all that this Gauranga Mahaprabhu, he is the most merciful personality who has ever appeared in the entire creation, in the history of the whole universe. You should simply, constantly glorify him, sing about his qualities, sarala hoilo man, with very, very simple heart, not with duplicity, completely surrendering and taking shelter of this Gauranga. Gauranga boliya nagenu galiya kemone dorinu de narahari hiya pashana diya kemone gori ache. Here Narahari Thakur, he is lamenting on our behalf, and he is feeling this way, that this Gauranga Mahaprabhu, who is the most merciful personality, somehow or other, my heart has not melted for him, even though he has come to give his mercy to all the jivas within this world. But I am just like, my heart is just like a stone. It is not melting, it is very, very hard. So this is the mood of our Vaishnava Charjas. They have realized, they are tasting this highest limit of prem ras that Chaitanya Mahaprabhu has come to give. They are realizing that if Mahaprabhu had not come, then no one in this world would have been able to understand. Everyone would have simply been very, very unfortunate. So this song is glorifying this mood of completely taking shelter of the lotus feet of Gauranga Mahaprabhu.
Thank you. Do you know who was it? Narahari Prabhu? Chamara Dhulai? Narahari? Or Narahari Sakur? Narahari Thakur? Not Narahari Sarkar. Different. He was Navadip Paikar, associates of Navadip of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, from very boyhood, and very first class poet and expert in singing. So you can realize what his heart was. He's telling, what telling? Oh, Radhara Prema Rasa Sima. This is the life that this is the goal of all living beings of the whole world. But in this world, very rare. Rare was, rare is, rare will. Very rare. We want to take you in a special rare for love and affection. So you will have to give up everything, worldly desire, then you can fall. Otherwise, if there is some smell of sense gratification, position, wealth, reputation, and very little, oh, you cannot fall. Never and never. You will have to make your heart like bansi, float. And float nothing, you know, anything. Only what Krishna will sing, it will sing. Nothing we have anything. No independence. Oh, we cannot say this. But what Krishna will sing, it will sing. Always empty. Then you will have to make your heart totally empty like one. No. Then you can follow something. And you can have this real love and affection of Gopi. Otherwise, never and never. So this is Amen. I told you. But very difficult to have it. So in Chaitanya Charitamrita, Vishwarup Damodar has told something about this. Raramananda has told something. You know that Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, himself Krishna. And he has agreed to fulfill his desire. How highest the pranay, love and affection of Radhika. How he realized, relished the sweetness of Krishna. And how he become to you overwhelmed. He came with the desire. He took the entrancing mood and golden color of Radhika. And for this he took sannyas, get his wife and everything in this world. His old mother, helpless, new wife, without child or anything. He became nirbhay, nishthu. That is, there is a ghat. Nidya ghat. He jumped in the Ganges and oh, like winter, like this. Jumped. And then he took sannyas. And then he went to Jagannath Puri. And making some trick, went to south. Why? To be admitted in the Sakhi Vishakha school to realize this thing. Understand something? And he went there. And he begged that you should admit my name in your register. I want to know something, please learn. And then what is wrong? What is affection? He learned everything from Vishakha Sakhi. Why Vishakha Sakhi? Vishakha and Radha are one. Birthday same. Qualities of
same nature.
Oh, by all these things, qualities. We cannot imagine. He knows all the moods of Radhika. So, he went there. and he was admitted in that school. And then Vishakha Devi kindly gave so many teachings to her. And also not only some realization of the Radhika, highest class of Madana Khamut. Without teaching, Krishna cannot realize. Now, when he was taught all these things by Rāyaramāṇḍa, by the Hirāṇ, and so many things, then he was really so much moved. And then he returned back. Oh, my Siksha Guru, you should come to Jagannath Puri. And then we will face to face release all the testness, test all the sweetness of God. And that is Siksha Guru Rāyaramāṇḍa. And in Gambhira, they used to always weep and be telling separation. And in separation, meeting also. But there will be separation. Internally, they will meet with Krishna. And in meeting, they will forget that internally Krishna. Okay? What I'm telling? You should clear. Again, you should. If anyone is meeting face to face, like Krishna is meeting with gopis and Radhika face to face, then he becomes happy, really. But internally he forgets everything. He cannot at that time taste his beauty and madhurima, that is sweetness and everything. Only face to face he will meet. He can embrace, he can do other things. But not truly and all side. But in deep separation mode, what will be? Internally they will be always remembering what Krishna was doing. Oh, beautiful thoughts. Sweet and charming, cheating words. Oh, gopis, they cannot take it. But at this next time, he became antardhyam. Disappeared and gopis began to be loved. Why this cheater do? And then they were avenging Krishna, you are cheater, you are black from side into inner side. And we don't believe in you. So there are so many things. Then, what I was saying, I forget, don't forget. Then, so in whole night, how? Krishna was dancing with gopis and cheating also gopis. And gopis also cheating Krishna. Oh, Narmala! What?
Joking.
Sweet jokings. How Krishna impressed gopis and gopis. Krishna impressed in their giving his hand in the neck of so many things you have to remember. By Vashantaras of with Govinda. Chandi Das, Vidyapati and all other things. Whole night weeping. His servant, Govinda Prabhu, was very sad. Why they came, Sarvara? Why they come and disturb Mahaprabhu? Always weeping. I don't want. They should go away from me. But he cannot do because that they are superior. You can see whole night. Not only one day. Every day, especially Mahaprabhu, choose to become overfed, weeping, sometimes jumping on the ocean. I'm thinking that I'm meeting Krishna in Narasa's Thari in Jamuna Bihar. Sometimes on Govardhan, sometimes in Vrindavan, Jagannath, Garden. So he was testing all this. With Raya Ramananda, same Vishaka. And what is this? This is the AML project. So high, how class. Only there were 3.5 only person who used to know all these things. Who were? Damodar, Raya Ramananda and Sisi Maiji. And half Maji. Only. What can you tell Farooq Goswami? What do we?
Goswami like disciple.
Oh, only remnants. Oh, all remnants used to take only alone. So, this end is very high class. You cannot erase any help. So, I want that you should all taste this. And have any greed for this in this life. If greed is there, and really, sincerely the greed is there. Oh, at any time, oh, you can. In lakh births, you can. That even it is short. So, now, we are coming. Radhaya, this is the time of Krishna. And that is why he became Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and took also the golden Yusuf Radhaya Pranay. No, why?
Om Gaurachimarandhasya Gaurandhanaslakaya Chakshuranvritam Jena Tasvai Sri Gurave Namah. Srila Gurudev ordered me to speak a few words in connection with this very famous verse which has been composed by Sri Swarup Damodar, who is incarnation of Lalita Sakhi. This verse is found in his Karacha, his notes. Sri Radhaya Pranaya Mahima Kidrisho Vaneva Swadyo Yena Bhuta Madhurima Kidrisho Vamadiya Saukyam Tasya Madanubhava Anuta Kidrisham Veti Lobhat Tad Bhava Jasanijani Sachigarbha Sindho Harindu. Here it is stated, Sri Radhaya Pranaya Mahima Kidrisho Vaneva. How deep is the love of Srimati Radhika? When Krishna was in Vrindavan, he saw when he was meeting with gopis of Vrindavan, and especially at that time when he disappeared from Ras Lila, how they became mad in separation. How at that time Radhika was crying, Yatte Sujata Charnam Buru Hamstaneshu Vita Shanaya Priya Dadi Mahika Kesheshu Tenata Vimata Sitavyata Te Nakimsut Korbadi Bi Brahmatiti Bhavadaya Shamna. O Krishna Chandra, why are you walking alone in the forest, in the dark? You cannot see where to keep your feet. You may step on any thorns. I cannot tolerate it. You are my life and soul. The fact that you may step on thorns, oh, I almost give up my life. I cannot tolerate this pain. Because of pranay, Sri Radhaya Pranaya Mahima. Pranay means feeling of oneness. Oneness of body, mind, heart, senses, everything. This is called pranay. How Radhika feels? Pranay for Krishna. Oneness for
no material world, nothing. This is not. Even a smell of this is not. Very easy.
In this world, even a smell of this kind of pranay or affection, feelings of confidence and oneness between lover and beloved, cannot find anywhere. Yet it was in Radhika. So much so that she's telling, I cannot tolerate the pain when you step on the soft, hard grasses and stones in the forest. What to speak of that? I cannot tolerate when I take your lotus feet upon my breast, thinking that they are too hard. Bhavadayu samnaha. Radhika saying, oh Krishna, if I cannot serve you, oh then I'll let the remainder of my life be added to your life. So at least I can serve you in this way. When Krishna saw this, he was struck with wonder. And at once he had to appear there. Tasama virabuchori smayamana makambade pitam baradarashagvi sakshat manmata manmata. He came running at once to appear in the assembly of the gopis. This prema of Radhika was so strong, completely controlling him. So at that time of separation, Krishna saw something of the pranay of Srimati Radhika. He tried to test how deep it was, but he could not find the bottom. Like a man in a boat may take a stick, and by the stick he tries to touch the bottom, but he cannot reach, so he leans over and further, and then he falls in the water. Krishna is like that. He tried to understand how deep Radhika's love, but it was not possible. He had to appear as Satinandan Gaur Hari with her complexion and sentiments, and to be under the guidance of the Lita Vishaka, that is Swarup Nanda and Roy Ramananda, and then he could realize something. So Krishna first, seeing the prema of gopis of Vrindavan, his first desire was, how deep is her love?